picture this. You just finished D2 year. You passed boards. Now it's time to start working on patients. My name is Stephen Raines. I'm a third year dental student at the University of Tennessee. And today we're going to show you what it's like to be a D3. So many things that I'd like to know. The best thing that helped me transition to this year in dental school was asking questions to upperclassmen and to my faculty. Every morning before we start working on patients, our clinic group gets together with our instructors to go over everything we're doing that day and to give them a chance to answer any questions we might have about any procedure we're doing that day. But what is reality? It's pretty simple. Get organized. When you make it to clinic, you're now the dentist, the assistant, and the secretary. It's really important that you keep your appointments in order, let your patients know when they need to come in, and keep yourself from getting behind so you can graduate on time. Before you made it to clinic, you probably had 2 or 3 hours in your schedule set aside just to do lab work. Well, now that's not the case. You need to make time in your schedule to do all of your lab work so that you don't have to stay late nights just to get a denture in the mail the next morning. Just above me, heaven's watching over me. My advice for other D3s, spend time with your classmates. It's easy to get really stressed out and feel so busy that you have to work through lunch. But definitely take time to eat lunch with your classmates, trade war stories, have some fun together, because your classmates are going to be what you miss the most when you graduate. I can't stop questioning. What has been both the most challenging and the most rewarding thing about being in clinic is just dealing with people. You spend 2 years just working on mannequins. Mannequins don't feel pain. They can't tell you things about their lives. And then you get into clinic and you start working with people. It's challenging, but it's also rewarding to build relationships with your patients. Go, why do they go?